Good morning, YouTube. So here are two of my 4S or 16 volt lithium ion battery packs. So each one is about a half kilowatt hour. And I need to turn two of these into one of these. So this is a 24 volt 7S battery pack, about 900 watt hours or 0.9 kilowatt hours. Let me rearrange things so we can work on them here. Okay, first thing I have to do here is pull off the power leads. I'll actually be reusing these with the 7S battery pack. So here I've got the short negative side, and then I've swapped out the positive lead for a longer wire, and that'll fit on the 7S battery. When I built the 4S batteries, I had all of the power connections in the same location, and I found that was a little problematic because this power connector was here, this one was here, and all the power lines got in the way of each other. So one thing I'm doing on the 7S batteries is every other one of these, I'm going to alternate whether I swap out the black side or the white side. So one will be like that, and then the other one will be over here. So I'll have the power connectors offset by a few battery modules, so that way the wires don't get tangled up. I need to just come in here, and we'll take off nuts and washers here. I'll be reusing all of these on the 7S batteries. Why don't I just flip this over this way? And then usually I can spin these out here. And there we go. Just repeat that a few times. Yeah, let's see, we'll get these all separated here, get the spacers out. Yeah, I guess when I put these together, I don't know why I got these out of order, so I'm gonna swap one and two here. So just to do that, I need to pull that out. There's another spacer. So we get one, and then two, three, and four. Doesn't really matter what order they go in. They're all about 35 amp hours. And one thing I want to do is, since I'm freeing up one module out of every two batteries, I'll be able to run a capacity test on this eighth module that I'll end up with here. So that way I'll be able to see what kind of degradation these cells have had over the last couple of years that they've been in daily operation. So let me go get the threaded rods and we'll start putting these back together. Okay, there's the threaded rods for the 4S packs. I think they're a little over 8 inches long. And then here's the ones for the 7S. I can get five of these out of a 6 foot piece, and I just have an inch left over, so it's pretty efficient. Anyway, then I take the nylon locknut off of the short rod, put it on the long one, and this is what I use for the driver. So let's see, let's get the washers on there before you start. So you got to kind of get everything set up ahead of time. You can see it's a pretty tight fit in these holes, so that's why you have to actually use the nut driver here. You gotta get it through a little bit. Get the two bottom ones here. There we go. Let's see, now you have to get four spacers. One, two, three, four. And you can slide these up together. Usually just get them started by hand there a little bit. And run it through the next one. Four spacers here. And one. There's two. That's a little tight fit in there. And got all my interconnects in here. And slide the next one in. Just repeat. See, it should be one. Oh, now we got to find the spacer there. Somewhere I usually end up losing one. Oh, I got two. Oh, shoot. I gotta pull this one apart here. There's the extra spacer. There we go. So now we have one, two, three, four. And slide that on. So now we have one, two, three, four in place. Yeah, so the next thing I need to do is I'll pull apart the other 4S pack, and then we'll get modules 5, 6, and 7 to go in here. So let me do that off camera, and I'll come back when I have those pieces ready. Okay, so we pulled the threaded rods and spacers out. So what I need to do is remove module number 8 here. So this is going to come out. So I've got one extra module left over. And I'll try running a capacity test on this after I get everything set up, and we can see what kind of capacity we still have. Yeah, now we have to move the jumper from that end over to this end because we're connecting packs 4 and 5 here. So there we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yeah, so there we go. We've got the 4 modules, and then we're going to add the 5th one here, get the hole started. Yeah, so now we've got that on there, get the next 4 spacers. See the jumper still on there. Make sure everything's all hooked up as you go. Yeah, it really helps if you leave a little bit of threaded rod sticking out. So if you leave a little bit of rod, it makes connecting the next one easier. Get this one. There we go. You got that one sticking through a little bit. Just a little bit of thread sticking through so you can get a nut on there. Yeah, the 7S are a little bit more cumbersome to work with just because you've got 6 spacers in there and trying to get all the spaces out of the spacers. There's that one, and then I'll redo this one with the washer under the nut. There we go. That should be pretty well hooked up. So there we go. We got the 7S. And what I'll do is put this in here. Here's the negative. It goes right there. And the positive comes around here. Let's just get that in place. There we go. So now we got one finished. And then just to show you here with the power connections, so that way I've got one power connection here, and then the other one is offset a few modules. So that should make getting to these a little easier. So I'm probably going to stack the batteries like this in my slide-out shelves. That way I can get, you know, twice as many batteries per shelf. I think the way they'll fit in the shelf is they'll be turned this way. So this will be the front of the shelf and the back of the shelf. And then I'll have another 2 batteries on this side facing in. And then I'll do all my connections here in the middle. So I think that'll leave me enough of a gap here to do all the balance cables and the power connections here in the center. Okay, there we've got 2 finished modules, about 900 watt hours or 0.9 kilowatt hours each. That's measured using 4 volts per cell, so 28 volts max voltage, and then with 3.7 nominal, 35 amp hours, and that's measured at the 4 volt charge. I get about 900 watt hours. This guy here, 27, 29. This one I think is a little bit higher. I took these off the charger 2 different days. About a 1/10 of a volt higher, 27, 39. So I'll get on my negative here. And so there's the first cell, 3.901. And the next one, 906, 905, 906. That one's a little lower, 902. 3.889. That's a little lower there. Yeah, 896. I took this off one day, and I took this off another day, so these two might not be exactly at the same charge. The first one, I took them all off on the same day out of my system. But yeah, I think that'll work. But let's see, as far as specs, 18 pounds for the 7S battery, which is like 8.2 kilograms. This is about equivalent, at least amp hour wise, to two of my regular batteries. That's about 70 pounds for two of my lead acid batteries to be 35 amp hour and 24 volts. Weight wise, these are a lot easier to move around. You know, 24 volts right here, 18 pounds. I can't pick it up with one hand, but it's easy enough to move with two hands. So next up, I think, is the balance cables. And then I can plug in the SBMS and the new charge controller and inverter for 24 volts. So we can get these guys going. So anyway, stay tuned to that. If you have any questions about the 16 to 24 volt battery conversion, go ahead and post up in the comment section below. And I'll put some of the earlier assembly videos where I showed how I put these together over here on the left side. And as always, thanks for watching.